Hey everyone, so I know what you're thinking. Giz, what a fantastic use of clickbait. Great title, great thumbnail. Everything sounds very ghoul. Ghoul? That's not a word. Everything sounds really cool. Now what's the real message? Well, it's not clickbait. I am quitting Lucid Dreaming. But not only Lucid Dreaming, I'm also quitting Lucid Dreaming videos on this channel. Before I get into the details, the explanations and all of that, I will first preface this by saying that this isn't something that I've just thought about off the top of my head. This isn't like yesterday cooking pancakes and I'm like, oh, do you know what? I'm just going to quit Lucid Dreaming. Even though it may seem like that from your perspective, I've been thinking about this for a very long time. And I mean a very, very long time. I have been stuck with the mantle of creating content on YouTube about Lucid Dreaming for close to maybe 8 years. And in March, I'm coming up to my 12-year anniversary on content creation for YouTube. And I've had some retrospect. I've had some time to think about things. So why am I quitting Lucid Dreaming? I'm quitting Lucid Dreaming simply because I don't enjoy it anymore. Don't get me wrong. I still think Lucid Dreaming is cool. And I still think it's the best thing you can do for free. Well, one of the best things you can do for free. But one of the best things you can do for free that helps you spiritually, mentally, physically. Not just lucid dreaming itself, but this skill and the skill set that you develop around lucid dreaming. So having better memory, being able to have a decent sleeping pattern, being thoughtful, mindfulness, all of those things, the skill set you develop from learning to lucid dream is just incredible. However, at this current time, some of you may know that I'm actually an insomniac. So I struggle going to sleep. And I think the reason is less to do with my body and my mind and more to do with some subconscious stress. And that sounds pathetic, but it's true, I think. See, I don't enjoy doing lucid dreaming because it's not something that I particularly want to do. I think of lucid dreaming in the same way that somebody else might think of diet or exercise. You start to exercise, but eventually, you know, you might tether off exercising. You might continue it, but most of the time, you're just going to tether off. A diet, somebody might try veganism or vegetarianism for a month, and some people will stick to it, but majority of them will not. Every person that I've met in the street, random people that have recognized me from YouTube, have all said the same thing. Oh mate, I used to watch your stuff, but I just got out of lucid dreaming. And it's the same with me. Some people do continue to lucid dream and study and research lucid dreaming, like Daniel Love, he's been doing it for donkey's years. You've got people like Stephen LaBerge, he's been doing it for donkey's years, like even more donkey's years, two donkey's years. And that's the thing that they do. But for others, like you, like me, it's not something that you do forever. It's a fad. It's like a phase that you go into, you study a little bit, you leave once you've experimented with lucid dreaming. And I started lucid dreaming when I was quite young. I mean, I had my first lucid dream when I was 5, and I started studying it when I was about 14. And when I studied it when I was about 14, I had like 5 years of solid lucid dreaming in which I was like so good at it. I practiced, I researched, I experimented, and I repeated all of that. And I was experimenting with so much stuff that I was like, yeah, that's cool, I'll continue. But then it came a job. I had to do lucid dreaming in order to be good at YouTube videos. I had to do lucid dreaming in order to create content on lucid dreaming for YouTube. And I was not enjoying lucid dreaming, or I wasn't into lucid dreaming as much as I was. So the more time I spent trying to create content on lucid dreaming, the less I enjoyed it. The less I enjoy it, the more I resent it because I have to do it because of YouTube. Until it gets to this point. I can't remember the last time I wrote down a dream. I created a podcast called the Dream Journal Podcast. That's still carrying on, by the way, just FYI. The Dream Journal Podcast is a podcast in which I describe some of the weirdest and wonderful dreams that I have in recent times. But at the start of each episode, I always say, this isn't going to be a regular thing because I don't know when I'm going to have a dream. And that is a cool thing to say. The lucid dreaming content, it's getting boring as well. I've been on YouTube for nearly 12 years. Probably about 10 years of those I've been studying. About 10 years of that I've been doing lucid dreaming content, and for about 6 years of that I've been doing primarily lucid dreaming content. And there's only so many ways you can say the same thing. There's only so many ways I can decorate a video to appeal to a new audience so that you learn about lucid dreaming. There's only so many ways I can do it, and I've done pretty much all the ways that I can think of. Even if I could do something else, I'm still bored of the content that I'm making. Like, I created The World of Giz, a second channel, to put all of my creative freedom into it so I can do any video that I wanted to do, any topic, anything that I wanted that wasn't lucid dreaming based. I'd put it in The World of Giz, and that would somehow alleviate that stress of being able to do lucid dreaming videos. But in the back of my mind, even though I had this creative freedom, I was still like, oh, you've got to do that lucid dreaming video. It was always there, until I just gave up on both. And I don't want to turn lucid dreaming into the reason that I quit YouTube, because I really enjoy YouTube. I enjoy consuming YouTube videos. I enjoy creating YouTube videos. But as it currently stands, I'm not enjoying it because of the content that I'm creating. Some of my favorite videos I've ever made were to do with me and the woman in Germany. Video series in which I was in Germany, loved it. Loved that video series. And it showed me that I'm missing so much. There's so much stuff that I'm not doing that I could potentially be doing. With a platform of 50,000 plus people, like, what am I doing? Why am I continuing to make content that I don't enjoy? How many times can I repackage the same message of lucid dreaming before people listen to what I'm saying? So that's why I'm stopping. It's kind of like Mexican food. It's like, to me, Mexican food's all the same thing. It's just wrapped and presented in a different way. It's like, oh, cool. Minced meat and guacamole. Oh, you're going to put it on some nachos. Cool. Oh, you're going to wrap it in a tortilla. Cool. It's all the same stuff. I know it's not. I'm speaking in hyperbole, but you know. On top of that, you've got all the stuff that I'm doing outside of YouTube, like creating a company. That's a thing. And I want to document that process in some way so that others can enjoy it. But who knows? Who knows how that happens? Deep down the root of all of this video, there's going to be no more lucid dreaming videos. I did think about doing one last one, but to be honest, the thought of that repulses me. So probably not going to be doing that. I've come to the fact that I need to take some time to decide what it is that I want to do. And that's not a bad thing. I've tried time and time again to create content on lucid dreaming. I'd go out, I'd come back, I'd go out, I'd come back, and I'd do the same thing over and over again. And people are starting to worry about me not making content, disappearing for ages, that kind of thing. But I don't think they are, because when I haven't posted since middle of January, and nobody's asked when the next video is coming out, which they used to do when I enjoyed making content on lucid dreaming. People are like, oh, when's the next video coming out? I'm like, yeah, I'll tell you when. But no one, not a single soul. So that kind of indicates to me that my audience is ready for this change. But what change is it? And that's where I come to you for advice. So there's loads of different options that I can do, but I don't really know what I want to do. So if you've got any recommendations, please let me know in the comments below. I'm sorry for everyone who is expecting lucid dreaming content consistently. There are other YouTubers that you can turn to. It's Tifero, it's How To Lucid. I don't consume their content because I'm not interested in lucid dreaming. One channel that I would always recommend wholeheartedly at the top of my list every single time would be Daniel Loves. You also got Spacetime Badass, you got the Rah Rah Rabbit, you got loads. I'll leave some links below so that you can decide for yourself who you'd want to turn to. If you want to unsubscribe, I understand. I'm not going to be posting content on lucid dreaming like you thought I would. And yeah, that's that. It's a weird time in my life. I've spent over a decade doing videos pertaining particularly to a certain subject most of the time. It's like nearly half my life. It's weird. So when I said at the beginning of this video that I am not taking this very flippantly, I thought a lot about this. That's the truth. 12 years is a long time, and I don't want to be spending my 12-year anniversary on YouTube doing the same thing. I want to evolve, do something different. Thank you to every single person, from Aaron to Zebedee. I want to thank each and every single one of you for the support that you've shown me during these 12-ish years of YouTube, specifically for the Lucid Dreaming stuff. I thank each and every single one of you from the bottom of my heart, no matter how cold or black that may be. I want to say particular thanks to all of the YouTube members who are still supporting me through this tough time. And don't worry, guys, you will get something in the future. If you want to unsupport me, I can understand. I want to say a huge thank you to all of the Patreon supporters who are still supporting me still through this tough time. The Patreon supporters are getting access to the podcast, the Dream Journal podcast, which you'll get on Patreon. It hasn't been released anywhere else, but you'll get it on Patreon. But that's for those who are supporting at $7 or more. Yeah, it's going to be a couple months of weirdness. Maybe I'll be gone for another week or two. Maybe I'll make a triumph. But then my content on this channel will evolve into something new, something different, something that I want to do. So I don't learn to resent video creation, because outside of YouTube, that's my job. I create videos online. If I don't enjoy what I'm doing, then that will affect my company, my business, and my work. So, gotta fix that. So, until next time, for the last time,